It's now daytime in the late Silurian reefs of Gotland. We see a clearer view of the stromatoporoid-dominated Hemsey Reef of the Ludlowian epoch. These layered sponges are mostly of the low-profile forms, and they coalesce into almost uniform beds in the substrate, leaving very few space for other reef builders. Here, we can find more oncocerids with strange shell apertures. Coming into view is Trimerocera cylindricum with its T-shaped opening. Trimerocera is unique in that as it matures, it sheds off the younger part of its shell, leaving it with this stumpy potato shape in the end. These very constricted openings suggest that in their adult form, they would have relied on very small prey like ostracods as their food source, and that their mobility isn't very great given the position of where their siphon would be. Trimerocera's bulbosum from a slightly older reef bed has a more bulbous, lowercase T-shaped opening. Pentamerocera's mirum has a more star-like aperture, and some fossilized shells have been found with this wavy pattern preserved. Another species from this genus, Pentamerocera facula, has a wider opening and a more pronounced ribbing on its longer shell. By this point in time, fish are starting to be more common in the ocean. In this particular reef, remains of jawless fish like Flabulespis have been found, as well as many scales of acanthodians, the so-called spiny sharks. This Inversoceras has to tolerate a curious Nostolepis, hiding into its small aperture until it's gone. Inversoceras also has a T-shaped opening, but its face is placed higher up and facing forwards instead of downwards. Here, Plemeroceras emerges among the tangles of crinoids. Its opening is similar to Inversoceras, but it's larger in size and its shell bulges more in the middle. Crinoids grow most abundantly in the flanks of the reef instead of within it. Their remains provide an important substrate for more sponges to encrust on. Not far from there, a large oncocerid has appeared. Jepsonoceras concentratum is 8 centimeters long and has a much wider aperture. so does this Clathrocera splicatum with its beautiful ornate shell. Perhaps these larger openings suggest that they predated on larger animals. However, they're still outmaneuvered by other nautiloids like this Ascoceras, which started off with a vertical orthoconic shell, but later sheds them off in favor of a horizontally oriented adult shell. Phragmoceras and Ophidioceras also prowled the waters, one getting a little too close to this Octameroceras sinuosum. Two Baltoeurypterus take a swim as the day comes to an end, plunging the reef into darkness. Octameroceras pugil sets out into the reef flanks to continue its forage.